Hi, this is Carl, the Landscape Guy. Today, foundations for a wood garage are to be made. Some have already been completed, but some are still missing. And in this video, I want to briefly show you how we make them. We use these so-called h-ankers, which must be set into concrete. These are for 120 millimeters wooden beams, but you can get them in other sizes too. Keep in mind that the anchor itself does not ensure a rigid connection between the foundation and the beams. In this case, however, a garage with walls is being built, and these walls provide a connection between the wood studs for an adequate stiffening of the building. The size of the foundation can be found in the construction statics papers. For this dual garage, statics were created. If the position of the foundation is calibrated, we can start to dig the hole. We use a spade and a shovel. You can also use a hole spade or a hand excavator. But in this case, it's spooky topsoil, and we use the spade to loosen the compressed peaty soil and the shovel to get the material out of the hole. With two people, we're pretty quick. The 35 by 35 centimeter hole was dug out in about 10 minutes. At a depth of approximately 1.2 meters, we reached load-bearing soil. Now the hole can be filled with concrete and compacted. In some areas, the ground level differs from the desired height of the foundation. Here we use an upturned bucket with a cutout bottom to get the desired height. We use precast concrete with a strength class of C25-30 and in 0 to 8 millimeter grain. In order to achieve the desired strength, a laywise compaction with a hand tamper is very important, so that the anchor is placed exactly in the right place. I have stretched a cord and marked the center of the anchor with a black dot. Now the anchor has to be aligned with the level. If it's properly seated, the concrete can be filled up to the top and compacted. The floor of the garage will be laid with pavers later. I make sure that the foundation is not in the way of the pavers. That way the foundation disappears later under the paving. Now only the concrete has to harden and the garage can be put up. If the sun shines strong and drying out the concrete before the chemical hardening process is completed, the concrete can be watered from time to time or covered, for example, with fabric. I wait a few days before I build the garage. The concrete is relatively hard after 24 hours. However, the hardening process is completed after 28 days. The bucket can now be taken off and reused if needed. As you can see, the H-anchors are sitting nice and tight in the concrete. I hope this video helps you. If so, please press like, and you're welcome to leave a comment for a question or ideas. Visit my channel for more helpful landscaping videos. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for joining us. See you soon. Good luck with your project. I'm Carl, the Landscape Guy.